Hi mommies, this is Tanya, Noor's mom. So today I'm going to be speaking to you all about, should your child be wearing Crocs? Or are Crocs safe for your baby, toddler or child? Watch this video till the end to know the answer to this question. So Crocs was originally developed to be a boat shoe or a water shoe, a shoe that was supposed to be worn on the deck. That is why, you know, they created it with such features. They made it with good quality rubber that doesn't spoil with prolonged use in water. Then they gave anti-slip or skid soles so as to prevent any falls or tripping from any kind of slippery or wet floors. Then they gave adequate amount of protection while offering breathable holes here so that, the shoe could breathe, his feet could breathe, and the water could also get dried up very easily. But over the years, Crocs has become much more than just a water shoe or a boat shoe. It has become a lifestyle, a trend. You see Crocs everywhere, on adults, on babies, toddlers, children. Whether you be at home, at the park, at the mall, all you see are Crocs. So, what are the reasons why children like Crocs so much? The most popular reason for kids to go for Crocs are, number one, they are available in a variety of colors. You can buy them in whatever color you like. Then you can customize them. You know, they have some kind of beads or some stickers kind of things available that children can buy and make it customized as per their likings or their cartoon characters. Then it is a very roomy shoe. Roomy shoe, that means there's a lot of room for your toes, and the baby's foot is very free. So foot is free, that means that there are less chances of any blisters or foot rubbing or, you know, those redness marks. And lastly, they are very easy to put on. They are like slip-ons, and toddlers love this. They love independence. They like things what they can do on their own. That is why they like Crocs so much, because they can wear it on their own. So no doubt, Crocs is a wonderful piece of footwear, and it has some wonderful features. So if you have seen my previous video where I have talked about what are the things that you should look for while buying your child's footwear, I mentioned some things that you should definitely look for. So let us go one by one and see whether Crocs has those or not. So number one, they should be very soft and have a good cushioning. So yes, Crocs are very soft. They're made of very soft material. They have very good cushioning as well. They should be flexible. Yes, Crocs are absolutely flexible. They should be lightweight, very lightweight. They should be made of a breathable fabric. They are breathable with holes and made of good quality rubber. Then they should have anti-slip or non-skip soles, and that Crocs has. Then they should follow the natural shape of the foot. And yes, Crocs do follow the natural shape of the foot, which is wider at the top and narrower at the bottom. Then it should have room for toes. It has room for toes, so very good. Then proper support to the ankle and the heel. No. So the biggest disadvantage of Crocs is that it doesn't have the most important feature that a child's shoe needs to have, that is proper support to the heel. So Crocs are virtually backless. They only have a very loose kind of strap here that does not give adequate support to the heel. It is just like a loose strap, but not a very snug strap. Now, because there's inadequate heel support or ankle support in Crocs, it can cause various problems. So number one problem, because it doesn't have adequate heel support, it is not a stable shoe. It does not provide stability to the child's foot, which is very important, especially for toddlers who are just learning to walk properly. So because of this lack of instability and lack of ankle support, it can cause twisting injuries. Can cause ankle injuries. Then when there is no proper support here at the back, the toes, the child is forced to curl his toes a little like this in order to maintain his grip. and that can cause toe deformities in the long run. Also, due to improper support to the heel, the child's heel is excessively mobile when he's walking in them or just running around in them. And overuse or over mobility of the child's heel can cause flat arches and heel pronation in the long run as children grow older. So like I have mentioned in the previous video about a baby footwear, babies, they don't have bones in their feet. Their feet are mostly made of cartilage, and it is only by 6 to 8 years of age that their bones develop. Also, babies are born flat footed. They don't have arches. Arches start developing by 16 months of age, and they continue to develop and fully develop by 6 to 8 years of age. So if your child is wearing Crocs for a very, very long time during these growing years, then there are high chances that he might develop a flat foot in the long run. And it can not just cause a flat foot, but even other feet problems like bunion toes, those broad toes where the toe bone comes out a little, hammer toes, tendonitis, plantar fasciitis, corns, calluses, blisters, toe deformities like I just said, and even toe discolorations. So because of the lack of proper heel support that Crocs does not provide, it can cause a lot of feet problems. And when our feet are not gripped well to the ground, they can cause problem in the hip and also cause problem in the back. So later on, when such problems come up, we don't even realize that a simple piece of footwear can be the problem for it. Also, Crocs, even though this is an advantage of Crocs, that it has very, very good cushioning, but over cushioning is also not good for our feet because it compromises on the foot's ability to absorb the foot step impact. So every time we take a step, our feet actually absorb some impact. So with an over cushioned sole, that ability is compromised, and our feet, ankles or arches have to work even harder, which can lead to overuse or strain injuries in the long run. Then they have very good anti-skid soles because they were made to be a water shoe. And because of this, sometimes children, toddler especially, when they're learning to walk, they don't know that when we walk, we should pick up our feet and walk. They tend to drag their feet and walk, and sometimes depending on the floor the baby is standing on, and because of these anti-skid soles, there is greater chance that the soles grip to the ground so well, and when the babies try to drag their feet, they tend to trip or fall. In fact, there have been so many reports that Crocs have got stuck in escalators that are usually there in malls, airports and other places like that, because of their anti-skid and grippy soles, because the soles are so anti-skid and they grip the ground so well that sometimes in escalators the child is just not able to get the foot on the next stair and the child's foot gets stuck. So this is also a very, very dangerous repercussion of using a Crocs. So does that mean that I should not buy Crocs for my child at all? No, I am not saying this. Crocs are an excellent piece of footwear made of great quality material, but they should be used only for the purpose they were created for in the first place. Either to go to the pool, beach, if your baby is using them at home, your child is using them at home while having a bath, or a very, very short walk, or say playing in the balcony. But Crocs are not supposed to be used for physical activities. They are not supposed to be used in times when the baby is physically active. The baby is running or playing in the park, going for a long walk with you. You are visiting the mall with the child, or the child is cycling. No, Crocs are not meant for all these physical activities. In fact, not just Crocs, but any slip-on shoe is not recommended for any physical activity. Parents should ensure that children are not wearing Crocs throughout the day. Parents should monitor that your child is wearing Crocs only for a maximum of 4 to 5 hours a day, mostly at home or going for here and there, or at the pool, or while having a bath or something. but not for long or not for any physical activities. For physical activities, your child needs a good supportive shoe that protects his foot, that gives him proper arch and ankle support, and also offers him that good balance and grip. And that can only come if your baby is wearing a proper shoe meant for physical activities. A shoe that has probably laces or it has a Velcro straps with proper support to the heel right till the ankle. Only those shoes need to be used. We need to understand that Crocs are not a replacement for everyday shoes. They are not to be worn throughout the day, because overuse of Crocs or prolonged use of Crocs can lead to various foot problems, problem in the back, and can also hamper your child's foot development. Because remember, a child's foot will properly develop only till he turns 6 or 8 years of age. So till that time, you need to make sure your child's feet are in the most appropriate piece of footwear as per the activity he's engaged in. So these were my 2 cents on Crocs. I am not discouraging you for buying Crocs. Please go ahead and buy Crocs, but just monitor the activity that your baby is using them to do. It's also a great way to teach your baby to put on shoes themselves, but at the same time, we need to take care of our children's feet as well. So I hope my video was helpful. Keep writing, keep suggesting topics. Take care. Thank you. Bye-bye.